The Stooges is a project that you have been working on for sort of years now. It's been a long time coming. Is it different now from where it was when you first started working on it? Did you change stuff over the years?
Yeah, you know, whenever it takes us a while to write it, to get a movie made, and that's happened a bunch of times. So like Dumb and Dumber took 5 years, you know, Something About Mary took a while. You know, you're always working on it, making it better. But this changed in the way, like, you know, there's a part of this movie where they split up. And Mo ends up being on the Jersey Shore, the reality TV show. Well, originally, when we wrote this 12 years ago, that was a Queer Eye for the Straight Guy he right. ended up on. They did a complete makeover on him. Mm-hmm. And then 5 years later, when we were about to make it, he was on the Hills. Mm-hmm. And then finally, by the time we were getting the movie made, we said, like, okay, what's the reality show now? And it was Jersey Shore, so we plucked him into that one.
Okay. So the Stooges, their humor has sort of, their DNA is sort of spread out through, you know, various things. You see them, things like Futurama and things like that.
Yeah.
And Kevin Smith's work, in some ways, you kind of see little references to them. Were you ever worried that people are so used to what they do from other things that then reintroducing the original source might make people go, oh, I've seen this already?
Not really, because they haven't seen this sort of broad comedy, you know, a slapstick, really. It's been a long time, and in fact, if anything, that's what made it hard to get the movie made. The studio was like, I don't know, is the audience ready for this kind of slapstick? And we felt as long as we put them present day, added all new stuff, put them in a real world, they would be.
Mm-hmm. Casting Larry David was kind of a coup, kind of a genius little move, making him play a nun. What was the thinking behind that? Was it just he would be funny in a habit?
Well, Larry David is arguably the funniest guy of our generation, if you think about it. Mm-hmm. You know, besides Seinfeld, which he created with Jerry, he Curb Your Enthusiasm. I mean, he's influenced our country more than, anybody. Mm-hmm. So to have him is just a no-brainer. If he'll do it, I'd put him in anything. And the fact that he would get dressed up as a nun and come out in our movie was an honor and a privilege.
How does one go about broaching the subject with Larry David, saying, hey, come be a nun?
You hit him when he's drunk, and then just hold him to it.
It's a good plan.
Yeah,
it's a good plan. You guys, there's been a lot of talk recently about sort of Dumb and Dumber sequels. Jim's talked about it a little bit. Is there any movement on that front? Is it now going ahead, and what is happening with it?
We are doing a sequel to Dumb and Dumber, and it's our first sequel. We've never done a sequel, and we purposely didn't. You know, we could have. You know, we've had opportunities. You know, there was talk about doing There's Something Else About Mary, and, you know, this kind of thing. But we felt like, and that felt like a money grab. Like, just like, oh, yeah, okay, so that would be it. It wasn't natural. This Dumb and Dumber was always natural. And finally, Jim called up. He just never wanted to do it. He was doing other stuff. Jim called and said, you guys still want to do Dumb and Dumber 2? Said, absolutely. So we called Jeff. Jeff was gung-ho, and we are doing it. We're going to be filming it, I think, in September, and I think it's going to be out summer 2013.
Okay.
If we're still here.
Yeah.